वेलकम टू थर्ड बीएससी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स वीडियो क्लासेस. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स एंड इंटरफेसिंग. नाउ इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई विल एक्सप्लेन एवेल्यूशन ऑफ 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड the controller development tools. Before going to our actual topic, we will discuss some of the topics of our last class. Okay, so in the last class I explained what is meant by a microcontroller. Here the microcontroller is an IC. In the last sim you all are heard microprocessor. In the last presentation we have discussed what are the differences between microcontroller and the microprocessor. Here the major difference between the microcontroller and the microprocessor is the memory. So here the microcontroller, what are the memory devices are there? Those all memory devices are manufactured in a single chip. That means the microcontroller is also called as small computer. Okay, so and also discussed Intel. Now in this paper we are discussed only 8051 microcontroller. The 8051 microcontroller is developed by Intel. So many microcontrollers are there, so many companies are developed this microcontroller, but mainly the 8051 microcontroller is very important microcontroller. Whenever the microcontroller is coming to the picture, the embedded technology is very much improved. So that's why a microcontroller is very very important in our any electronic gadget. That means without any electronic gadget our the microcontroller is very essential. So now in this presentation we will discuss the extension of evaluation. In the last presentation we have discussed types of microcontrollers. In these types the microcontrollers are mainly classified based on bits, based on memory, based on architecture, based on instruction set. But in this syllabus they asked the evaluation, that means based on bits, only based on bits. So now in this presentation I will explain evaluation in based on bits. And also and another topic is microcontroller development tools. Your syllabus is very less the unit in unit number 1. So these are the three topics are very much important. So first one is the introduction, evaluation and the microcontroller development tools. Now we will see the evaluation of a microcontroller. So here microcontroller are classified on the basis of internal bus width, architecture, memory and instruction set as 4-bit, 8-bit and 16-bit and 32-bit microcontrollers. So first one is a 4-bit microcontrollers. The 4-bit microcontrollers are small in size, minimum number of pins, and it is used in low power applications like LED, LCD, crystal displays and portable battery chargers. So likewise, here the 4-bit microcontrollers are very popular, that is M34501, which is a 20-pin DIP chip. DIP means dual in package, with a 4 kilobytes of ROM, 256 bytes of RAM, 2 counters and 14 I/O pins. Similarly, ATMEL 862 and ATMEL. Okay, so here these are the 4-bit microcontrollers. Yeah, the 4-bit microcontrollers are mainly used in small applications like LED, LCD, crystal display drivers, portable battery chargers, so etc. So these are a 20-pin IC. Its memory is 4 kilobytes of ROM and 256 bytes of RAM, 2 counters and 14 I/O pins. Now we will move to an 8-bit. So here 8-bit microcontrollers are also very popular. So 55% of all CPUs sold in the world are 8-bit microcontrollers. The 8-bit microcontrollers has a less number of buses and also perform the arithmetic and logical operations on a byte instruction. 8-bit microcontrollers are 8051 microcontroller. So that means 8-bit microcontroller means here it will perform the 8 bits operation at a time. So that's why it is an 8-bit microcontroller. Now this 8-bit microcontroller is developed in the 1980s for the use of embedded systems. Other 8-bit microcontrollers are 80031, 8052, Motorola, AVR microcontrollers and PIC microcontrollers. Okay, so these all are the examples of 8-bit microcontrollers. Now come to 16-bit microcontrollers. When the microcontroller performs 16-bit arithmetic and logical operations at an instruction, the controller is said to be a 16-bit microcontroller. The internal bus width of 16-bit microcontroller is of 16-bit. These microcontrollers have increased memory size and speed of operation when compared to 8-bit microcontrollers. These are most suitable for programming in high-level languages like C and C++. They find application, disk drivers, modems, printers, scanners, and servo motor controls. Examples of a 16-bit microcontrollers are Intel 8096 family and Motorola MC68HC12 and MC68332 family. The performance and computing capability of 16-bit microcontrollers are enhanced with greater precision and comparable to 8-bit microcontrollers. So here the 16-bit microcontrollers are mainly developed for using of high-level applications like disk drivers, modems, printers, scanners, and also it uses the high-level language C and C++. Okay, so these are the advantages to use the 16-bit microcontrollers. Okay, so next we will move to the 13-bit microcontrollers. So here the 13-bit microcontrollers are used in high-speed applications like automobile control, communications, networks, robotics, cell phones, GPRS. Next one. These all are the examples of 16-bit microcontrollers. So one of the major 16-bit microcontrollers are ARM-based microcontrollers. We have already discussed these topics in the last video, but your exam point of view, what you have to write, the question is asked like this. You have to write and you have to explain all these 4 bits. That's why I will tell you these separately, 8-bit, 4-bit, 8-bit, 32-bit, so likewise. So mainly the 32-bit microcontrollers are used in a microcontroller applications. That means commercial applications. The various manufacturers who are supplying various types of microcontrollers suitable for different applications depending on the power consumption and available features. The ARM7 and ARM9, these all are the 2 types of a 16-bit microcontrollers. ARM7 means Advanced RISC Machine 7 and ARM9 is Advanced RISC Machine 9. So what is the difference between ARM7 and ARM9? There is some of the differences are there. So what are the main differences? What are the pipelining technique we are used in the ARM7 and ARM9? This is different. For ARM7, we are using 5-line pipelining technique. But in ARM7, we are using 3-line pipelining. And ARM9 is used 5-line pipeline technique. So these are the differences. But nowadays in our every electronic gadgets, they are using these processors, only ARM7 and ARM9 processors. These are very popular nowadays. Using microprocessors all are based on this 32-bit controllers. Next, we will move to the microcontroller development tools. So here the microcontroller development tools means here how a program will be write and how a program will be dump into our microcontroller. So here in our microcontrollers are the digital systems. That means it can understand only the binary values. That means whenever we have to write a program to any language. So that means C, C++, whatever it may be the language. But the computer or a digital system can understand only low level language. But how to write a program and how to execute a program. So these all are discussed in this microcontroller development tools. That means there is a step-by-step procedure is there to write a program, to execute a program. So these steps are discussed in this microcontroller development tools. Okay, so here this is a microcontroller development tools diagram. So here we are using an IDE. So here IDE means Integrated Development Environment. Here this is an editor. Okay. So here editor means what is meant by an editor? Editor means whenever we are writing a program, it will be checked by an editor. So what are the mistakes are there for writing this program? So that is called as an editor. So mainly here the editor is IDE. IDE means Integrated Development Environment. Okay. And next coming to see the, this is an RTOS. RTOS means what are the operating system we are used. That is called as RTOS. RTOS means Real-Time Operating System. Next one is an assembler. So assembler. So what is meant by an assembler? We already heard the word, that is assembly. Assembly means whatever the language we have to write, that means C or C++, whatever it may be the language, that language will be converting into assembly level language. Okay, so here this is a macro assembler, and next one it will go to the library manager. So here library means what are the instructions we need, so those all instructions are stored in this library manager. And next come to the C compiler. So here mainly the microcontrollers are used the programming like C or C++. Here compiling means execution of a program. After whenever the editor will check the program, if case any errors are there, it will corrected by the editor. Without errors, then it will be converted into assembly level language. After that, it will go to execution program. Okay, so here it the code, whatever the file is there, that file is called as a source file. After that, it will be converting into assembly level language, and after that it will be converting into hexadecimal language, that is the low level language. The file will be stored in a hex dot file format. Okay, so here this is a target monitor debugger. Here debugger means in writing a program, there is any errors are there, it will be check out, it will be clear that errors. So that is called as a debugger. Okay, and finally it will goes to device programmer, target device for the application. So here these are the developing tools. Here the major tools are the editors, assemblers, and the next coming to the compilers and debuggers. So these all are the developing tools. And next coming to how to write a program. So here these are the programming steps, how to write a program. So user can write a program in any language like C or C++, but a computer or any digital system can understand only low level language, that means hex code only. So that means whatever the language we are used to write a program, so that will be converting into hex code, and follow these steps. So here first one is editor program. So here editor program is nothing but here whenever a programmer can write a program in C language, after that it will be stored as .asm format. That means here file name .asm format. So and after that this format will be go to the editor, it will be check if in case I have write a program in C language, after writing of a program I will check it is ready to execute or it is any errors are there in that program. So that operation is performed by the editor, and also the file is stored is in the format file name dot asm. And next coming to the assembler programmer, if editor can correct the errors and modify that, then it will be give to the assembler. So what is the main use of an assembler? Assembler can convert the main source file. It is myfile.asm is called as a source file to assembly level language program. So that means in our microprocessor we are already written some programs. So those all are the assembly level programs. So those C language will be converting into assembly level language. So in this assembler, the program will be stored in file dot first. Okay, and next one it will go to the linker programmer. So that means object file. So linker programmer is nothing but the object file. So and after that it will be go to the low level language files, that is the other program. So that means it will be stored as file name dot abs. And after this program, that means after the execution, that means it will be ready to compile the program, it will be stored as my file dot hex format. Okay, so next in microcontroller developing tools, there are so many types of developing tools are there. So those are the software developing tools and hardware developing tools. So here we will discuss about the software developing tools. They asked in your syllabus only the software developing tools. So here the software developing tools are editor, assembler, compiler, debugger and simulator. So these are the some of the software developing tools. And next coming to the hardware developing tools, emulator, device programmer. So these all are the hardware development tools. Now we will move to the hardware development tools. Okay, so here the first one is an editor. So what is the main purpose of this editor? So here an editor is a program which allows us to create a file containing assembly language statements for the program. Example of some editors are PC write word star. As we type the program, the editor stores the ASCII code for the editors and the number of successive RAM locations. If any typing mistake is done, the editor will correct us to correct it. If we leave out a program statement, an editor will let you move everything down and insert a line. After typing all the program, we have to save the program. This we call it as a source program. That means the editor can create a file name. Okay, so here that is called as a source file. If in case any mistakes are there in the typing mistakes, so this typing mistakes will be corrected by the editor. Now we move on to the next step is assembler. So in this editor, the file name .asm format it will be stored. Next coming to the assembler. Here an assembler is used to translate the assembly language mnemonics into a machine level language, that is a binary code. Okay, so here the assembler means it will convert the mnemonics. Already to held this word mnemonics. Mnemonics means move A comma B, move R1 comma A. So like some mnemonics are there. So these mnemonics will be converting into binary code. When you run the assembler, it reads the source file of your program from where you have saved. The assembler generates a file with the .x file. That means after the assembler will converting into binary codes, the main file is stored is in the form of .hex. That means hexadecimal format. The file consisting of hexadecimal values, encoding sequence of data and the starting offset or absolute address. Okay, so in editors, the program is stored is in the form of file name .asm. In assembler, the data is stored file name .hex code. Okay, so this is nothing but an assembler. So here assembler is a software. That means software or a tool that translates assembly language into machine level language. So an assembler is a type of a compiler, and the source code is written in assembly language. Assembly is a human readable language, but it typically has one-to-one relationship with the corresponding machine code. Okay, so in assembly the code is also called as an object code. The file name is stored as filename.asm. And also next coming to the deassembler. A deassembler is a computer program that translates machine language into assembly language. The inverse operation to that of an assembler. Okay, so and that is object to file name dot asm. Now we will move to another software tool, that is a compiler. A compiler is a program which converts high level language program like C into binary or a machine code. Using high level language, it is easy to manage complex data structures which are often used for data manipulation. Because of its case, the flexibility and debug options, nowadays the compiler have become very popular in the market. The compiler like Keel, Write and IAR Workbench are very popular. Here mainly we are using a compiler is a Keel software. Okay, so here the 8051 microcontrollers or an embedded microcontrollers are used this compiler, that is a Keel compiler. So here the Keel means it is a software, Keel software. By using that Keel software, embedded microcontrollers or 8051 microcontrollers then compile their programs. Next, coming to debugger and simulator. A debugger is a program which allows execute the program and troubleshoot or debug it. The debugger allows to look into contents of registers and memory location. Of registers and memory location and run the program. Some debuggers allow to stop the program after each instruction so that you can check or alter memory and register contents. This is called a single step debug. A debug also allows to set a breakpoint at any point in the program. If we insert a breakpoint, the debugger will run the program up to the instruction where the breakpoint is put and then stop the execution. So a debugger provides for menu and commands as follows. Here the debugger provides start or stop debugging. Next one is performance analyzer, that is to find execute time for the function for the specified address ranges and display in the performance analyzer window. So next one is a breakpoint. Open a dialog box for the breakpoints, insertion or deletion and breakpoint settings, enable or disable current line breakpoint, kill all breakpoints and deassemble all breakpoints. Next go to next breakpoint. Next come to step and step over by executing one step into function and executing single step over function. Next coming to step out of current function. So these are the some commands for the debugger. A simulator is a software program which virtually executes the instructions similar to microcontroller and shows the results. This will help in evaluating the results without committing any errors. By doing so, we can detect the possible logic errors. These are the some of the simulator points. A simulator helps debugging and thus in the development of the tested system before the final target system is readed. It is used during the development phase. A simulator does target debugging. It selects a specific microcontroller version in the family and specific peripherals for simulation. It simulates the hardware performance for the software to be embedded in that without actually employing the specific device or a microcontroller. And finally, the last one is library and linker. The library is an order specifically formatted program, the collection of object codes such that the linker can use required ones directly for linking with another newly developed source file. The library manager helps in creating libraries. Linker creates an absolute object module from other module. It takes object modules created by an assembler and a compiler, or it takes object modules created by an RTOS, that means a real-time operating system. It takes only the needed object modules from the library. An absolute object file has all code and data at the fixed non-locatable addresses. Object to hex converter. It converts object files to hex files. Okay, so these are the some library and linkers. Now these are the some of the development tools for microcontrollers. Here your software developing tools are editors, and the next one is the assemblers, next one is the compilers and debuggers and simulators. These four are the software developing tools. These are very much important tools. Okay, thank you.